Alright guys, in this video, I'm going to show you guys how I make my surf casting rigs for shark fishing. You don't have to have a big conventional reel, like an 80 wide, 50 wide, or even bigger to go shark fishing up the beach. You can use a surf rod and a spinning rod, say from 5,000 all the way up to 10,000 reel, just to go shark fishing up the beach. You don't need those big giant reels. That's why in this video, I'm going to show you the way I rig up my surf rods for shark fishing. Very simple, very easy, and very cheap at that. This video is to show you that you don't really need a big 50 wide, 80 wide just to go out to the beach and catch sharks like everybody else. You can still catch good sized sharks from this, 4 foot to a 6 foot, 7 foot, 8 foot range, which is spinning tackle. The only thing you'll need is I like to use a number 9 wire. 180 pound test. You can go bigger if you like. You can also crimp it, but I'm just going to show you guys how to do a haywire twist just for simplicity. Plus, everybody doesn't have a crimper. You're also going to need a 7-0 all the way up to a 10-0 circle hook. I wouldn't go no bigger than a 10-0 hook, and I wouldn't go no smaller than a 7-0. You're also going to need a swivel. This swivel right here is a 250 pound swivel. You can go, I will go no more than 300. I want to go no less than 100 pounds swivel. Thing you're going to need is a simple snap-on swivel, some beads, clear colored plastic, doesn't matter. The next thing you're going to need is a pyramid sinker ranging from 3 ounce all the way up to 6 ounce, depending on the current. And the final thing you're going to need is some monofilament. Anywhere from 80 to 100 pound mono will do just fine. First step is, I'm gonna move this to the side, is your wire leader. Go ahead and cut you off. Go ahead and cut you off about a 2 feet section. It'll be just plenty for wire leader. And grab your hook. I'm gonna show you with the 10-0 hook. Just for bigger, you want to do a haywire twist. Go ahead and bend it over like this. Go ahead and cross them. Kind of like a 45 degree angle. And I like to pinch it. Just twist it. You see that, how it looks like that so far? I'm going to zoom in for you guys. See how it's starting to twist up like that? That's what you want. You want to do it about 3 or 4 times. So twist and twist. Now you're going to bend your wire to about 90 degree angle. See, 90 degrees, and go ahead and do your barrel rolls. I like to go about 3 or 4 times. It's 3, 4, it's going to do 5. Now when you have this, you don't have to take some nips and break it off. What you can do is just bend it back and forth and actually make a clean break, so you won't be able to cut yourself with this wire, because this wire will poke you. Let's bend back and forth. You see that? Now you won't even get cut. It's nice and smooth. Hey, there you have it. Are your hooks connected? Now you want to do the same thing with the barrel swivel. And get you some. Same way. Haywire twist. Some barrel twist. Now usually I don't use single strand. I like using coated wire and crimps. That's like the cleaner look. And do the barrel twist now. The reason I'm showing you guys a single strand is because it's a lot easier. Not everybody has a set of crimpers. And crimpers can get pretty expensive for the good ones. Single strand work just fine. You just gotta watch it and make sure you don't get no kinks in it, because once you got a kink in it, it's pretty much no good. So you can go ahead and bend this off like you did the first one. Back and forth, like so. And And there you have it. And there you have it. Haywire twist the barrel with the swivel. Same thing with the hook. To not circle hook. That's step one. Alright guys, now that we got our wire tied up, that's time to move on to the heavy monofilament. I got 100-pound monofilament here. I will not go no less than 80, and probably no more than 120. I like to tie just to improve the clinch knot. Just go around about 4 to 5 times. One, two, three, four. Go in through the back, out. You go to just give it a little saliva. Go ahead and pull tight. Now you just go. You can go ahead and leave a long tag in. I like to leave a long. Sorry, the leader's scraping against the camera stand, making a horrible noise that you probably hear on camera. Now you can go ahead and leave your tagging on here. A lot of people do, or you just cut it a little short. That's what the knot looks like. I'm gonna zoom in on that for you guys. Here's your knot. You can go ahead and leave the tag in, just in case it has any slippage, but I like to give a nice pull tug. You know, it ain't gonna go anywhere. But that tag in is not really gonna deter away a shark if he's eaten. You have this tied up. You wanna go ahead and get the end of your line. And that's your first bead. You're gonna slide it all the way down to the end. I'm just gonna hit that with the swivel. Now you wanna grab your snap swivel. I'm dropping leader everywhere. Stick it through the hole. That's what she said. And just go ahead and slide that all the way down. Now what these beads do, it's gonna help you with the chafing if this rubs against it, but it's also gonna stop from this messing up your knots, and that's what you really don't want, because you have a knot on this end right here, and you have a knot at the very end attaching to your main line. So you go ahead and add the other bead too. This is pretty much a modified fish finder rig, if you guys know what that is. It's gonna have a sliding weight on your line. So when the fish grabs it, the weight's gonna stay in the sand. Let me show you. And you're gonna snap, put your weight on there. And that's it. That's the attach this to your main line. But when you attach this to your main line, especially when you spin and tackle, I recommend you guys tie the FG knot. If you guys don't know how to tie the FG knot, I got a video. I'm gonna leave it up here in the corner. So just click on that. That way, is though, when you tie an FG knot, you'll be able to reel this long leader through you guys, and maybe some of it on your spool. And it'll be very easy to cast out there without it hanging up in your eyes and getting messed up. But what the purpose of having this weight here like this is, say it's, you have your bait, you cast it out on the beach, say about maybe 30, 50 yards. This is in the sand. So you have your weight here, you cast out 30, 40 yards off the beach into like the second gut. Your bait's sitting on the ground, weight's here. So when the shark picks this up, weight's gonna stay. And the purpose of having this swivel and beads is when it pulls, it's just gonna, weight's gonna stay, it's gonna pull lines. The shark's not gonna feel no tension. You're gonna hear your drag going off, that way you tighten up and set the hook. So usually when the shark feels tension, most times it's gonna drop the bait. That's why most people, when you go shark fishing, they leave the drag extremely loose. Alright guys, and that's my rig I use when I go shark fishing off the beach using spinning gear. Shark fishing in the surf. If you like these kind of videos, don't forget to like, comment, subscribe.
Hello, don't you know?